say? Merry Christmas, Spinning Town? Well, can I come on in and talk to you? Well, I'm going to, Ann. Is that fair for me? Okay. All right.
It's always kind of fun to get the news first. I
I think I'm going to start on with Curtis. Thank you. How are you, Curtis?
Fine.
Yeah, easy for you. Are you 6 years old? I understand you're doing very well in school. You're one of the top students in your class, is that right? Why are you a top student?
I don't know.
Kids of all, kids of all. Kids of all. Oh, why not? You're just a good boy to have around, aren't you? Now, I understand from one of my ads that you like to sell jokes. Is that right? Are they the kind of jokes that we can tell the family? Are they? Do you have a joke you'd like to tell? Don't you? Do you have any Christmas jokes? Do you have any jokes about your teacher? You don't have any jokes at all. But you're forgottable. Yeah. Well, now that we know all about the tradition, why don't you tell me what you'd like to
know?
All right. And if everybody could wait, and then we'll all sing a song and open them at the same time. Thank you. My gosh, that's so nice tonight. You don't think it hard about your Christmas list? You got most of it ready for me? You don't get the top of it? Oh, you don't know yet. When do you think you'll know? The day after Christmas, maybe? Well, I'll have you surprised enough you may forget your list. How about that? Let me see. I'm doing very well in the second grade. You're also a top student. Is that right? And what makes you a top student? You don't know either. What's the teacher's name? Miss Sandy. You know Miss Russell? She's in service. She likes her. Thank you. And does Mrs. Russell like you? I do. Yeah. You can dance there again on the... What's that, a show thing? You travel around and do some shows with Mrs. Sandy? Oh, one's going to be a big one. A bigger one. They're coming to school for Peter Pan. Is that right? Is that fun?
Yeah.
Did you have any speaking parts that would be just quiet?
Okay.
You like to do that? Well, it's good. You did love to draw and jump the rope. Help mom and dad around the house, is that right? You know, the thing I like most of all is you're a good girl and like everybody. You like everybody. Do you even like your brother? Do you? I think your biggest brother, you even like him. Christian and Curtis are like the boy. Well, that's very, very good, sir. Now, I know, even sitting on my lap, that you have thought of something. And I know that if I were to ask you one thing you wanted to take me, I know you would say. But why don't you give it a try? Your face and hair are the bargain. Well, that wasn't too hard to think of. I'll see what I can do for that. Is there anything else you need to think of? Okay, now the hard part. Have you been a good girl or a bad one?
Yes.
Okay. Well, okay then. I'll see you on Christmas Eve, and I know I can decide. Okay. Well, bye-bye. Hey, Kevin. My gosh, I like those fingers. That would look nice if my Santa Claus spoke, wouldn't it? Where did you get those fingers? From your mom. Boy, that's very nice. I'll have to have Mrs. Claus make
You like this place?
Well, it's very good. All of this season for the old family like their pieces. That's good.
I bet the trip to those too. Seriously, I do that every time I talk. Is that right? What deal am I going to have to make? Kirsten and Kirsten what? Oh, the doll. You think Santa could keep that straight, wouldn't you? Oh, I see you look really great in the class, and you're a top student. And that's because you like to do math very well. And so, I do that. And how's the situation going? Yeah, fine. Now, they're kind of annoying when you eat. Well, I've never had braces, but I have a lot of friends that do. And you know, the fun part about growing up is the bigger you get, the less you need them. And then they take them off. That's probably a couple of years away, though, isn't it? How long will it take?
1 year.
1 year. Oh, you're lucky. 1 year? Doing well in karate. What are you doing in karate?
Oh, that's the thing.
You get you up a lot. And get you up a lot. Are you in practice for it, huh?
Well, I
bet that makes mom and dad happy, doesn't it? I bet. You was John in the school play, Peter Pan. And you like computers in school. Is that right? And you're a very nice boy. Tell me a little bit about computers, please. What's your favorite thing? Bruce Lee, the computer? Oh, I understand. Kind of goes with the garage part, doesn't it? Well, tell me, do you have your list ready, Kevin?
Yeah.
Well, why don't you tell me what it is?
Okay,
Kevin, now tell me, have you been good or bad? You've been good, and is there any more cure? Nothing more. Okay, I'll put down good, and we'll get you a present right here, and you have a little bit. Okay. There you go. Okay, Kirsten. I'm sorry, I always mess up your name. Is that right? Why do you think that is? It's weird that we mess it up, you think, or it's a weird game to mess up for? What do you mean by weird?
It's a weird game
that
people don't
mess up. Right. Even when you look at it, it looks like something else. Huh?
Yeah.
You got your list ready for Santa this year?
No.
You don't?
I don't want anything.
You don't want anything this year? Not a thing. Oh, my gosh, that is on the load out quite a bit from here. How's your sixth grade? It's fun. What's your favorite thing? School. Obviously, when you get Student of the Week awards, that means you want to do something, huh?
Mm-hmm.
And you like to work in the library, and as a library aide, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
When you graduated from the Tokyo Ballet,
mm-hmm.
Does that mean that you can stand up on your toes now without any help? How long does that take?
3 or 4 months.
3 or 4 months to break them in and get back to the mm-hmm. How do you do that? I've always wanted to.
Just
half so.
Yeah. And then
you got to step. You actually stand right on the tip of your toes?
Well, you have to see that. And I've got to
talk to you. I think it makes you feet.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh, I've always wondered about that. And I've spent years in fire and resort. Peter Pan. Mm-hmm. And there was Mrs. Darling. Mm-hmm. And a pirate. Mm-hmm. Quite a contrast, isn't it? Mrs. Darling and a pirate. How does that work out? I think it's nice that all the old children are growing up more responsible and nice young people. I think that's good. Now, what do you think I should bring Mom and Dad?
Well, I don't know.
You are in the first grade, 6 years old. Do you have your list ready for that? What's it going to be? What do you want for Christmas? I thought we were going for a good fast list. A man and a doll. Well, what makes you be thinking about it, okay? But sometimes I scare my 6-year-old son. Oh, and it's a surprise. Okay, I love surprises. You're doing very well in school, and in reading. And you're a dancer with the group called the... Let's see, is that the Twinkle... What is it?
The
Star. The Star, is that right? You're on the Star. Do you like to dance? Boy, I understand there's a lot of kids on that Star team. Lots of groups. And what are you, a mini star?
Mm-hmm.
I'm shocked to be one of the mini stars. And I understand you danced in the Hope of America. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
And lots of other performances. Mm-hmm. And how about show dancing? Are you into that yet? What are you going to be associating on how to do if you're dancing on the show?
Mm-hmm.
You think you ever will?
Mm-hmm.
You do? Pearson could teach you how, I guess. Do you think she could? Maybe. That's true. You were on TV. Tell me what you did on it. What did you do in that? What did you do in that? Is that right? Is that kind of scary to be on television? Well, it's scary kind of what I'm on. I don't care how many times I do it, I still get frightened when that camera turns on. And you did a play at Weaver College called Christmas Tears. Is that right? And your part game was Jennifer. And I think you did a good job. You don't do that? Oh my gosh, when do you have time to go to school? You're busy with your mother, aren't you? Yeah, does Mom teach you how to be busy?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, she doesn't do it all by yourself? Because you watch Dad, right? Now, we've got a map and a doll and some surprises. And if you want anything else, nothing else. Okay, now, Courtney, you just have to tell me, have you been good or bad?
Yes.
Good. Okay. Well, we'll see. Okay, bye-bye. Here's what I have for you. Okay. The package is about as big as Courtney, isn't it? Okay, Trevor. Tell me. Age 9, is that correct? In the fourth grade. Okay. And let's see. In February, you were in a play, and you played. George Washington, wasn't it? Was that fun?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Are you in any other plays right now?
No.
Nothing. See, what else do I have down here? Oh, a Beacon and God Award in the Cub Scout.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember last year we had quite a talk on the things you liked to enjoy. Are you still inventing these things? Do you remember something you told me last year that you've invented? Something you told me how it works. What have you invented this year?
A toy boat and I'm working on Dad's joke.
Oh, built the G.I. Bill. Are you going to sell them to someone, or do you just to yourself? Do a lot of reading. And you want to see what this award is for. How do you get that award? How many books do you have to read?
I read,
now
it's a
pastor
being
from
10 to
20.
I read over
30. Is that right? What kind of books do you like to read?
All kinds.
All kinds? You like to read about space people? Do you? And do you do hobby reading as well? How to do hobbies and inventing? Well, that's good.
I cannot see
around the house with the sources here, I understand. That's better than last year, isn't it? You're going to have everything cleaned up for Christmas for me? Going to your room look really nice? And you're sitting along good with the family and cleaning the house and doing responsible things at school. I don't know if there's anything bad in that body this year, is there, Trevor? Sounds like you know what not to do, huh? But what do you do to avoid an argument?
Just try and
not do anything. I see. And just walk away and say, okay, is that what you do?
Sometimes.
Well, that's a very good history this past year, Trevor. And I want you to keep up the good work, okay? Because that's very, very good. Now, let's move to all of the things you'd like to do. Why don't you tell me?
I want a whole bunch of boxes, books, and a lot of other books. The prizes, Melody Kit, a couple of Play-Dohs.
A couple of Play-Dohs. Okay, well, that's a pretty good list, and you're doing a lot of things, it sounds like, that makes you a good boy. Now, the house, is this a brand new house? How long did you live here?
1 year.
And do you like it?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Do you like your school? What's the name of your school?
Roosevelt Red Dome.
Roosevelt Red Dome. Sounds pretty awesome to me, the Red Dome. Okay. And, and you've been working out with weights a little bit, getting pretty impressive muscles. Did you like to do that?
Yeah.
And what did you do in the summer? Did you help Grandpa on the oranges, or did you help the oranges?
Mm-hmm.
Help Grandpa. Did a lot of work, huh?
Yeah.
That's good. And you do a lot of fancy tricks on the bike.
Yeah.
What do you do on the bike? Is this an ordinary two-wheeler? Did you do that? Did you ever tip over?
Yeah.
Piece of food. That's the bad part, huh? When you juggle.
Yeah.
What kind of things do you juggle?
Well,
sister and brother. And I understand right now you're having a little trouble juggling all the girls in the car. Yeah. Do you have any selection made yet on which ones to stall most often?
No.
Good boy. You're 13 years old, and my gosh, you got 40 or 50 years before you have to make a decision, don't you? That's a good thing. Okay, carry on, anything else? Okay. Now, good. Has he been good or bad?
Okay.
Okay. I would just say that. Would we say that's above or below 50%?
Honest.
Okay. Well, thank you for being a good boy. That's what you call planning, huh? I like it when Santa's so predictable. I like it. How are you? Good. My gosh, you just got back from Spokane, Washington. Tell me what you're doing up there.
Well, I'm
in the teacher very well?
Yeah.
Oh, you do. You'd have to know your teacher pretty well for 8 pluses, wouldn't you?
Mm-hmm.
And you like school, don't you?
Yeah.
Good. Your T-ball team, the first in the city?
Yeah.
Did you ever strike out in T-ball?
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's just kind of embarrassing when you strike out in T-ball, huh?
Almost impossible.
Almost impossible. Did you have one of those stands that you kick the ball on?
Mm-hmm.
Did you? Have you ever hit the stand?
I hit it once, but the ball is falling yet.
Way across the room. That was kind of fun.
Mm-hmm.
I had one of those Nerf balls sitting on top of it, and one of my elves dared me to hit it, and my gosh, I hit that stand so hard, I broke that little plastic bat right into. You don't use plastic bats, do you?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, boy, you have to be careful, because they need bread. It's so cold up there.
Uh-oh.
Your soccer team? And the bat didn't take first, did it?
A little off.
If there were 10 teams, would you say you were right near the bottom?
Fast.
Well, why do you think your team was in the last position?
Well,
because
we had
when you played soccer, the other team played really well.
And how's the other team
playing? Well, the team that always beat us,
no matter what, well, we are
playing
against them in basketball, and we are killing them.
Is that right? We're going to get even, huh? Well, great. How's the G.I. Joe holding up? Do you need more this year, or would you like
to?
You need 3 more here, I know. Which ones do you need this year?
A diamond fast draw, and a lot, and when they run the draw, and 2 points of earth.
Oh, boy. Cool. And then that'll make your collection complete, won't it?
Yeah. I don't like it.
Okay.
Surprising on any teddy bear.
Surprising any teddy bear.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I've got a surprise for you. I know about Lori Rudolph. Do you want to tell us about Lori?
No. Come on.
What is a young boy like you doing with a girlfriend named Lori? Is she your girlfriend, Jimmy? Or just a friend with the girl? Oh, I'm trying to help you out. Where does Lori live?
She's kind of living in our backyard, but not quite.
I bet you know where she lives, though, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, John,
mm-hmm.
Have I got all of your list?
Yeah.
Okay. And I want you to be a very good boy on Christmas Eve and do well in all the things you're doing, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Now tell me. Have you been good or have you been bad?
60-40.
Oh boy, another smart one, huh?
60-40.
60%
bad, 20. Well, I don't think it's quite that
bad.
You think we could have it about 50-50 time Christmas comes?
Okay.
Or maybe 60-40 good? I can live with that. Okay?
Yeah.
All right. Well, we'll see you, John. One thing I noticed with all my friends this year is that they're all listing surprises in the first category. That kind of is a good option, you see. And then two other things, but surprises is first. Every. Gosh, Trevor, you're growing up and getting to be such a young lady like everyone in the family is growing up.
Yep.
How's everything going?
Fine.
Good. Let's see, I'm saying your report card made you a little money this year.
Sure.
And exactly how much you got? Is that $50?
Sure.
And how much do you get paid for A?
$5.
Oh, boy, you did very well there. This is good.
Uh-huh.
And how many are you going to get paid this quarter?
Hopefully 50.
Hopefully it doesn't.
Yeah.
Does it look kind of scary?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I bet you can do it. Now tell me about this violin that you got to be putting on. You don't like to keep it in your locker, do you?
Uh-uh.
Now why? Is it too big?
No.
Is it?
I'm my locker partner.
Oh, I see. Is your locker partner's violin?
No. He doesn't like it.
Oh, your partner doesn't like it.
Yeah.
I see. Does your partner want to buy the violin?
No.
He wants to sell it. He wants to sell it. I see. Well, I think if you lose the violin, Mom and Dad would be really upset, wouldn't they?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So how are you going to solve that dilemma?
Well, my friend doesn't care. My other friend doesn't care about his own thing. And she has a violin, so I keep her violin, and her locker with her violin.
So that's the way to solve it then, huh?
Yeah.
Well, I like to see some way to work it out. That's good for me. You're dancing this year?
Mm-hmm.
Well, are you dancing with John? In the same? In the Nutcracker, they just play.
Yeah.
And what's your role with you?
In the
Nutcracker. What part?
I'm
a party girl. That's nice. And how about a Dave and Blowin? Oh, well, that's a cute one, huh?
Yeah.
Which part do you like the best?
Both
of them. You playing the piano again?
Mm-hmm.
Are you taking lessons every week?
Yep.
And the violin?
Yep.
Gosh, multi-talented. Which do you like to play the most? Both good things. Oh, I see. Okay. And I understand you're going to get your fellow views. I see. You hope you get them for Christmas?
I hope I get them.
I thought you said that.
Okay.
Keep your room clean and Josh's room clean and your mom. Is that right?
Uh-huh.
I see. Sometimes. I think it sounds like maybe that's not true. Once in a while you keep them clean or dirty?
Clean.
Yeah. Okay, now tell me your list.
Okay, I don't want to go to the store.
Well, I'll see what I can do for you.
Okay.
And keep doing all the things you do, okay?
Okay.
And do them very well.
Okay.
And if you think good or bad,
I'll be really good.
Really good. Okay, my dear. Bye-bye. I know Seth's been waiting for this.
Okay.
Seth. That's cool. That's Tina. Did you say she's okay? Or would you rather not talk about Tina? Okay, then we won't talk about Tina. I understand you go to their dancing. Right, watch dancing?
Mm-hmm.
What do you do there?
Yeah.
Dance. And who do you dance with there? I knew you'd bring her back up tonight. You go to school, Tina?
Yes.
Huh? Tell me about your science fair project. What are you doing?
Science fair project?
Mm-hmm. What type of project? That's a good one, yeah?
Yeah.
And it's going to be the definition of atoms and molecules and the secret stuff through the atmosphere. Is that right? I don't know what I'm saying either, so tell me what kind of a project you do.
I'm
a girl. That's good. And you're doing it, what kind of approach are you taking? You're doing dark and gas or something?
Yeah.
Have you got it put together yet?
No.
When do you have to have it done?
January
14th. I bet you'll have it. I hope. How's the grades doing this year?
Yeah.
Okay. You're performing in Baby Toyland? Is that right? And what are you playing, Baby Toyland?
I'm playing
a trumpet. Ah. You still doing any trumpet?
Mm-hmm.
A little bit? Still taking lessons?
Yeah.
going to be getting the Gupta version. Well, we've got a lot to do, haven't we? Okay. Now, how about your list? What would you like?
Some
cake. Anything else?
Some clothes.
Some clothes. What kind of cake? Blank, just that? Oh, you want them already recorded.
Yeah.
What types of recorded cakes?
Okay.
Yeah, what kind of music do you like?
Rock
and roll. Okay. Now, cake, clothes, what else? And some surprise. Okay, Seth, good or bad?
Uh-oh.
50-50. Good, Seth. Okay. Well, we'll see. You have a merry Christmas. Everybody get around me. Why don't we pick up Santa's bag and hand it to Santa? There we go. I've got some surprises in there, so you just got to keep it by me, okay? How are we doing? Look at all those cameras, Chip. Can you count the cameras? Oh my, there's seven cameras over there. My word, some of them are roaring. Look at the little red light on the one. My gosh, it's like being on candid camera, isn't it? Okay. Just one more minute to Santa gets into the big kids now.
Oh, great.
Yeah, we're going to start with the biggest kid of all. This year first. We're going to talk to Grandpa Don, okay? Seems to me you just can't seem to sit still. If there's something happening somewhere, anywhere, you've got to be there. Is that right, Don? Mm-hmm. You're an artist, especially go out of your way to support activities and events for your grandkids, and you get involved. I think that's great.
That's mandatory.
That's mandatory.
Yeah.
Well, it sounds like you're not a good decision.
Yeah.
Sure. And so I've got an award for you for being the Globetrotter of the Year, okay? And this is for you, and that's a certificate from Santa for all the work you do for your family. Okay, Don, have a Merry Christmas.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, artist. What are you doing this thing, anybody?
It is.
It seems like when anyone's got a problem they can't solve, they call you. Is that right? And when something's lost, they call you to find it. You can be relied on for your psychic powers, they tell me. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. So what I've got for you is an award for a certificate of excellence for your psychic effusion.
Oh, wonderful.
Okay. You need to show that right next to Don. Okay. Okay. You have a Merry Christmas. I didn't ask you. Have you been good or bad this year, Don?
Good for what?
Well, good for what?
Yeah. Compared to what?
What do you think, guys? Has Grandpa been good this year? How about Grandma? She's been good this year. Okay, and we're going to put good for both. See, no matter what you still come out over there.
Yeah. They know better
than all. That's right. Okay, Trace. You've done a lot of social entertaining this year, I understand, especially for the cast of various plays. Okay.
Thank you very much.
You've been a good boy this year.
Yeah.
All that kind of
this year.
Oh, well, that's very well. Okay, Jerry. You always have so many things going on that it's almost impossible for you to do everything you've committed to. Is that true? Oh, you bet. Come on. There we go. Remember the time you sat on my lap and wanted it all?
Yeah.
$400. And you got $400 and you're still getting them.
Yeah,
isn't that nice?
Yeah,
it pays off to sit on Santa's lap.
It does, doesn't it?
Between the two of you, I think you're going to have a whole house full of collections, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think that's great. I love to look at them. But now, let's see. You've been really busy. And you've learned to compensate for being so busy by getting other people to do things for you. Is that right? You're especially creative. You were especially creative when it came to the story about locking your father-in-law's keys in his trunk. That was very unique. Therefore, I'm giving you this certificate of recognition for your creative delegating. Okay. Well, look what I have right here, and you get to stick that right next to Trey.
Okay. Great.
That's very quick thinking, don't you think?
Yeah, I thought it was
going to
work. Yeah, I did.
Okay, Brent.
Yeah.
I'm impressed with your generosity and willingness to help people. I was especially impressed with how you helped your bishop when he needed additional storage space. Therefore, I'm giving you the most generous gift giver award. That every year you have a major home improvement project going on. Therefore, I'm giving you this certificate of achievement for your ambitious yearly home improvement program. Okay? There you go. You bet. Quite a year this year, haven't you? Let me see. Had an operation and some chemotherapy and a blood clot in your leg, but none of these things get you down. You're consistently maintaining a super great positive attitude, and so I'm giving you a certificate of recognition for your outstanding positive mental attitude. You betcha. There you go. Okay. Now, have you been a good girl this year? Despite everything, good attitude. Okay. Okay, Brianna. I've got an award for Brianna. I don't know if he's going to like it or not. Because you're trying to save money by cutting your own hair, I'm presenting you with the Bad Haircut Award. Okay? You bet. That's a great one. I don't think it's too bad. Okay, Anna. You get to sit on my lap and see if May brings some dolls for you this year. Sure. How are you doing? Good. Do you have any special desires for Christmas this year?
Yeah. Diamonds.
Curtains. Emeralds. I see. And how's the house prepping doing?
It's well.
So you have, huh?
But we have a house.
Yeah, it's a beautiful home. Now, your bravery and determination in standing up to your school personnel. I'm giving you the Sticking to Your Guns Award, okay? This must be, is there anything you'd like to tell me about that?
Okay.
I understand there's a lot of gun sticking going on lately. You bet. Merry Christmas to you. Well, we've got got through the hard part and we found out who's good and bad and who's naughty and nice, I think. We understand what you want for Christmas. And now you're sitting there with your packages all ready. But before I say open them up, I'm going to do a couple of things. I have something in my bag for you as well. So I want you to come up and let me give you something. Then we're going to sing Silent Night. Okay? Then I'm going to read you a story. And then we'll open up the presents. That sounds fair?
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll sing Silent Night. And then we'll read a story. And then we'll open the presents. Come up with one more thing for you. And I have one of my elves make these for you guys. It looks like I dropped that one on the way, didn't it? Is that okay? I can give you one that's not broken. There you go. You bet. There you go. And I can trade you one for the book. There you go. Just keep them both. What a deal. That's a nice trade, huh? Okay, let's sing Silent Night, okay? Without any snow, without lighted windows and sparkle and glow, the laughter of children and the tree plump and tall, the fresh bit of mistletoe hung in the hall. Wouldn't be Christmas without friends so dear, to share in our happiness year after year. A hearth brightly glowing with smiles sweet and fair, and the music of Christmas on the crisp wintry air. Wouldn't be Christmas if faith didn't live. If peace was an ours and a parts didn't give, without warmth and gladness to brighten the day, and old, dear old Santa Claus, so jolly and gay. Wouldn't be Christmas without those we love, without angel voices we hear from above, the sweet, friendly greetings of holiday cheer, and old Santa's words with Merry Christmas to all, and all a happy new year. Okay, well, Merry Christmas. I'm going to be on my way. Get to bed early. Be good kids. Now open your presents, okay?
Well, she's all right. She's helping me tonight.
Probably pretty.
Yeah, I've suppressed before.
Oh boy. But get ahead.
Nice looking gal, isn't she, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, well, let's see. Find out who. How's that, huh? That's just about your size, yeah. Okay?
Just hold on to it, Jack.
Huh?
Oh,
and presents. Got all these presents?
Oh, my goodness. That's a candy. Thank you, please. So can I take it in your door?
Oh, sure. You
for my princess. Go sit by Josh, please.
Why?
Please, meet in the video, so we don't just have one person in the video. Okay, turn it off for a minute.
Hey, I'm over here. And it came. Decrease from Cazier Augustus.
Caesar
Augustus. That all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was the first made when Cinnius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went to Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house of lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, that faith would accomplish that she would be delivered. And she brought forth the firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for him in the inn. And there were no same country shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them. The glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be unto all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which the Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the baby wrapped in swaddling clothes in a manger." And suddenly there was the angel multitude of heaven, the host praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, on earth peace, goodwill toward them." And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from into heaven, shepherds said one to another, "Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord has made made unto us." And then came in the haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child.
Thank you, Josh.
Welcome. Okay. I mean to sort out the presents.
Fair and kids. Flat, cherry, flat, move your feet. My body, I'll fall off the couch.
Lay down.
Cardboard.
A box.
Yes, both of them.
Give
me your garbage.
I'm opening this one. Hey, here.
this, Jeff.
Nutcracker.
This is the cart.
Yeah.
I thought it had your name on it.
What?
Didn't it say Jeff from Jeff every from Mom and Dad and Jeff?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
His
wrapping paper.
Yeah, that hurts.
Okay.
Holy cow.
Careful with the bite.
Sorry. I was the one who ripped it. Okay, I'll open this one.
Everyone ripped my box open.
No, that's me.
Oh, boy.
Oh, man. Okay, I got an open one now. Oh, I just kind of ruined the bowl.
Save that nutcracker box, Jeff, to bend it in the air.
That is me.
Yeah, stuff on him.
Fuzzy?
Fuzzy stuff.
Yeah.
Let's hope we didn't get this one confused.
Well, you have to get confused right off the bat, and then everything else is okay.
I guess I'm a decket now. No. No.
Here, cool. Take your finger down and split the tape. That's why you're here. Not
yes, it is.
You haven't been peeling your finger.
She showed me the other day, and they looked pretty good.
Holy moly,
Khalil.
Okay, I'm going to put something that went in
his
hand.
Oh.
That rock.
Is
it glass? Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Isn't
that sweet? That's the first one.
Man,
that's
did
the first
it?
One, right? Yeah.
38.
Take off the prize.
That's
it.
Okay,
I'm not sorry. What's that?
Break TV right there. I got it. I'll give you a
T0. Hey, bring me your garbage. Hey, Seth.
No, it's your turn.
Deborah's like, I'm going to do that.
Oh, okay. He's cute.
I'm doing it. That one's from Mom and Dad.
Okay, this one's from Mom and Dad.
And Seth.
And
Seth. And Seth. Mom,
what?
Well, Mom, at least I got the thing you need.
Where's your toe shoes, Deborah?
Okay.
She gets toe shoes for Christmas. Are they cute?
One for each toe.
Uh-huh.
What is it? My turn?
No, wait a minute.
Oh, man.
Did you give that to you too?
Uh-huh. Oh, Mom, Jeff is still having trouble opening this.
Wait a minute.
Hey, those might be your toasties.
I'm sorry, you got your toasties.
We just
gave
you your
toasties. I already got my toasties, guys.
Other way.
Maybe in Taiwan.
Who's that from?
Anna.
I wonder what this could be.
Mm-hmm. That's sharp.
Oh, how cute!
Oh,
look at that! Oh, how cute! Okay, now I'll do this one.
Now you'll be the hottest one in the violin class.
Oh, shit! Alrighty, call it! Alright! Thanks a lot, Dev.
What was this next?
Well, down in Salt Lake they have, but it's the most unusual school where you can make.
I've seen it. And they've got
it's
the painting on the
it's
building.
It's the only one.
Hey, another present for you.
Tell you.
Gorgeous.
can. I mean,
well, Debra could go down there and learn how to make
flour. Learn how to make flour.
And then they have to farm over there.
This is from Santa.
Decide a minute who gets to open that. I think it's mine.
It's my present.
The biggest box for the biggest person. Looking pants, Steph.
Yeah, they are. That's a neat outfit.
I got some guest shirts too. It is a box.
Oh, really?
A box. Oh, so cute. What is it? Oh, it's a piece.
It's sterling silver nutcracker.
Okay.
Terry, you need to take this to the
customer. Today.
Did you like your dwarf?
Yeah.
It's a dwarf, but it's like coming out of the bottom of his shirt. It's so weird.
He sat that way his whole life. He sat that way in his high chair. He always had his knees up here. He always looked deformed.
That's what I was going to say. You need to take a picture of
that.
Ah, I can't
see.
Mom,
how do you hook this?
It's Trace and Cherry. Here, you want me to put it on?
Yeah.
Deb,
your turn.
I know.
Wait a minute. She's sitting on Sandy's neck crack her hand close.
No, you can't go yet.
We got one. She's sitting right there in a white sweatshirt.
Hi,
Zelda.
Okay, now.
Is that it? Everybody opened all the presents? I don't know. Let's, what should we do about that? I don't know who it's to.
I think it's mine. Didn't I order Shutter for the living room?
Mom.
12 years ago. I think it's my Shutter, isn't it?
Somebody else open it.
I'll let Josh open it. I think it's my Shutter.
Yeah! All righty!
You like my Shutter?
It's okay, Josh.
Who brought that?
I don't know. You did, Josh.
I think you helped.
20.
Oh, Seth?
25 points!
Uh-huh. Seth?
Yeah.
Grandma gave you and Grandpa gave you part on your cereal. They got the speakers for you.
Oh, thank you. You have to read all the tests.
Okay, Dad, we're going to spend most of the day
putting
this together.
Baby?
That's my baby. Don't you think I got enough G.I. Joe?
Say hello.
No.
That's my baby. That's my baby.
Uh-huh. Turn around.
Your face. Your face. Now I know the perfect place to put it.
Where would you
like
it? Sit by your step and I'll take your picture.
I know. Way to go.
Okay, we got this is to Dad from Seth.
Now we got exactly what she said.
I'm gonna sit in the sunshine.
We got exactly what she said.
What'd you say?
G.I. Joe. Oh, my own brushes. Keep your hands off.
Oh. Not me.
Thank you, guys.
Mm-hmm. It's your children. Okay, my turn.
Hold on.
This is from Penny. Maybe it's the cookies. Shoes.
Now we have two of them.
Did they go to Mexico again?
Yeah, they did.
They gave you anything.
We like them. Thank you, Penny.
Now you have a pair.
Okay, again.
How do you turn it off?
This is from, oh, we got these last night from Dick and Sharon. Some cute towels.
I want to zoom in on one thing.
This is from Burley.
What?
I'm going to push it back the other way.
Oh, okay.
A notepad. This is from Steffi.
Uh-oh.
Where'd the garbage go?
Way over here. This is what from
Mom,
Seth.
Mom, you kind of got it kind of backwards.
This isn't from Seth?
No.
Yeah, it is.
Open this up.
This way. Oh,
okay. What's the grin?
Because
you can't fit in the box backwards.
I did the tapey.
Oh, thanks, Dad. Seth knit me a sweater.
No.
Paper.
Nope, this side.
Oh, here.
Oh,
okay. Well, this is exciting.
You're gonna love it.
Am I gonna love it?
Yeah.
Can I do this?
Yeah, you can.
Can I tip it over?
Yes, you can. You're gonna love it.
Am I gonna love it? Oh my hat, did you make this?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's beautiful.
In the
thank
pack,
you.
Look at that.
Oh my goodness.
That
look at
is
this.
Sweet.
Is it full of many?
No, of course you allow one.
See, here's where you put all your cards and this is why you put all your checks.
Is that right?
Thank you,
dear. Wow. That is beautiful. Thank you. Yeah. Where's your grandma and grandpa? How nice. Well,
we
thank
had to
you.
Get the leather and we had to hammer it and get it all back in the crumble.
Is there anything else to open?
Nope, we're through.
You have done with the dragon crown. He opened his mouth so wide that the wind of snow went right down his throat and put out the fire inside. When Darcy realized the fire, then a shout. And the last to know that he could speak without starting another fire.
Yep, I cut his head off.
The gallop was late on the trip, and he was up and up with a roar. He ran to the village and he cried out, "My fire, he am no more."
Hi, Steffi.
Hi, Dad.
Okay, I need to put the stickers on. Look at this gun.
Come back again if ever
Mom. Mom.
Mom, where are we going to put this owl stuff?
Having fun?
Mom, where are we going to put my owl stuff? Okay. Yep.
Oh, thank you.
You've got bows all over.
Bows for your hair.
Wait, Mom, get that.
But you're bending over, Cannon. I was trying not to take a picture, but... Okay, ready, everybody on that side of the room. Hello. Carrie, Carrie, take your face out there. One, Kevin.
Kevin.
Two.
Two.
Thank you.
I'll go first. I'm not going to give it to you. Yeah.
I'm just getting a quick shot of him.
Your dad.
Battery.
Well, hey.
Brianna.
On me.
Oh, hi, Trace.
You just write Debbie on all the presents or what? Yes,
they're on mine. Hi.
That must be for me.
Here's Josh. You want to take that over?
No, he heard you. Come on, get it.
Sherry, did you have a Merry Christmas today?
Oh, oh, oh.
Did you have a Merry Christmas?
Am I supposed to look at you or the camera?
Me?
Look at me.
I had a very nice Christmas. Thank you, Jared. Thank you, Jared.
Hey, Jared, let's see your tie. That's good.
Thanks, probably a dog. Let's go down a little bit.
There.
Yeah.
Better
than you, watch this. Yeah.
Okay.
Come on.
I think
that's
box.
Yeah.
Oh, the only one you didn't have.
Chris, I have more than enough. Mom, look. Mom, I have Jack Daniels.
I'm sure.
Thank you, Grandma.
Give her a hug.
Thank you, Grandma. Let's not change her hair.
I mean, I give up.
What have you got, Josh?
Oh, cool. I got it.
I don't know if they put batteries in it. Let's
look. No, not yet.
Give Grandma a hug. Oh, this is what I wanted for Christmas.
Are you Mrs. G.I. Joe?
G.I. Joe, walkie talkie back. Do I look happy?
Oh, thanks, Grandma.
Oh, she's bizarre. Isn't she fun?
She got different.
Look at those ties. I love her. I like her.
She comes from different colors.
Oh, what'd you get?
One thing you don't have.
Another.
What can I give you? I put them off.
Yeah, open them all for me.
Where do I go? Here,
I
want to
bug you.
No, I didn't need any for the
trash. Wait. It says low light.
What's that? Wow. I wonder how they knew our light.
We don't have the battery.
Won't Santa like to do that? Because it makes me really feel good with your family party when you guys help me sing. So what should we do this year? Should we start Silent Night?
Rudolph.
Well, we're going to sing Rudolph, but we're going to sing Jingle Bells too. So let's start with Silent Night. I like that. All the big kids over there sing loud too, okay? Okay. Silent night, holy night. All is calm, all is bright. Round yon virgin mother and child. Holy infant so tender and mild. Sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. Very, very good. Now let's sing Rudolph. How about that? Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose
like the light bulb.
And if you ever
saw it,
you would even say it glowed
like the light bulb.
All of the others. American history.
Columbus.
All right. Boy, you know that part so well, don't you? Well, that's great. We might as well get right into my book tonight because I have an awful lot to talk about. We've got good grades and we've got winners and we've got people on television and we've got a lot of people playing in the Nutcracker.
And Lorraine, who has the least in it.
And we're going to start with Let me see.
Right,
I have
Lorraine
a list
Marcus,
about Lorraine
yeah.
that is so big.
It did fit in the book, did it?
No. Well, Lorraine, why don't you come on over here to Santa? Sit right over here on my knee. You know, you've been working so hard to get that doctor's degree that we want to just take a break and sit back and relax at Christmas. Okay?
Fine.
Now, is it because I'm coming you have to run away, or is it just that you have other things to do? Well, I understand that. And I understand you've been working so hard to get that degree that you've had to put a lot of things off. Is that right? And sometimes it takes a long time to get a lot of things done. Well, tonight I have a special badge for you, and this is what I'd like you to do, and that's around to it, okay? That's when I get around to it. So you keep that ticket, and when you get around to it, you can get caught up on those things, okay?
All right. Thank you.
Okay, bye-bye. My word. I remember when she was just a little girl and she got so many dolls for Christmas. Do you remember all of those dolls? Yes, I bet she does. Okay, well, let's start here with Kirsten Ellis, 12 years old.
Kirsten,
I do that every year. Santa, I don't know. Maybe it's just because I'm getting so old, do you think? How are you doing?
Just fine.
I understand that you're doing so well in school, and you, let's see, what grade are you in now?
Seventh.
In the seventh grade. Let me see some of the things you've done. You finished the sixth, and you received the Hope of America Scholastic Award. Played softball last summer, received the Most Improved Player Award.
Mm-hmm.
Word, and you played in Alice in Wonderland when was Alice in the school?
Mm-hmm.
In the school performance. Going to T.H. Bell. And I understand that you're right close to a 4.0 in the highest honor society, is that right? Looking for all the bad things. I have reports on everyone, and I don't see any bads down here. You keep a list of those, and we'll get to those in a minute, okay? Second counselor in your beehive class, mm-hmm. in the Zimmer Dancers, took first place in the team dance competition, and in the Nutcracker as well,
mm-hmm.
performing in Salt Lake and Austin. How did it go the last 3 days? Just okay. Didn't go great.
Well, the first time you got yelled at.
Oh, I see. Was that your fault or everyone's fault?
Probably everybody.
Everybody's fault. Well, tell me, what do you want for Christmas?
Clothes.
Some clothes.
Mm-hmm.
All kinds of clothes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Anything else?
Nope.
Nothing else. Tell me one of the bad things you do.
I don't know.
You don't know.
I can name a few.
Yeah. Oh, everybody. Aha. Can you think of one bad thing you'd like to do better?
Nice.
Well, that's a good challenge anyway, huh? Now, have you been good or bad?
Probably 80 good and 20 bad.
80 good and 20 bad. Is there anything else you'd like to tell Santa? Okay. Well, thank you, and we'll see you. Merry Christmas. Okay. Kirsten is getting so big, I remember Kirsten just so small, and I'm going to put good 80%.
80% what he's
going
to give you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sorry, guys, 80%.
Okay, Kevin.
Steady, go.
You're the one your sister keeps fighting with. You know it takes two to have a fight, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. And you never fight with your sister, do you? I thought you did just a little bit. 10 years old this year, is that right? You've been thinking about what you want for Christmas?
Yeah.
What do you want for Christmas?
Nintendo and sports stuff.
You have a Nintendo already and now you just want some new games?
No.
You want the whole outfit, huh? Okay. What else do you want besides the sports stuff?
Nothing.
Just Nintendo and sports stuff, huh?
I can probably get 2 things a year.
I see. That's all right. That makes you happy, doesn't it? Do you like the things I brought you last year?
Yeah.
Well, that's good. Well, let's see how you've been doing this year. Fifth grade in Mrs. Salisbury's class, is that right?
Yeah.
In the school chorus, and was one of the ugly stepsisters. Did you like to do that? I understood that you stole the show in your performance. Is that true? I bet you'd make an ugly stepsister. Good job, Dad. Second place in the hump shoot contest. Is that right? My gosh, that's great. I bet you could outshoot Santa Claus, couldn't you? No, I bet you could. I'm not very good at basketball. The ball gets so cold it won't even bounce off the hoop. And you like to play all types of sports, don't you? What's your favorite out of soccer and basketball?
Basketball.
Basketball.
I can't turn pro in
soccer. Oh, so you want to turn pro in basketball. Well, if you keep working out like John Stockton, I understand he's kind of your idol. Is that right?
Next to Michael Jordan.
Well, I understand that you did so well with your 100 push-ups and sit-ups, you got an autographed basketball from John Stockton from the Jazz. Is that right?
Yeah.
Boy, that sounds like a pretty nice gift to me. Where do you keep that?
Up in that room.
Up in your room? Do you ever play basketball with it?
No.
Oh, I wouldn't either. You'd bounce the letters right off of it, wouldn't you? Let's see. You like to play with older boys, and you do get along really well with them. Is that right? Oh, you can beat him in basketball. You sound like John Stockton, don't you? Have you ever met him?
No.
I bet you will someday. And he was a narrator for a Christmas Day parade or a play at church, is that right?
To be on Christmas.
You're going to be on Christmas? What do you have to do in that?
Talk.
You have to talk. Well, most narrators talk, I think. What you going to talk about? Ready to do that?
No.
You're not? Well, you've only got about a week. You'd better work pretty hard, huh? Yeah, are you playing basketball right now? Are you on a team?
Yeah.
Are you in a city recreation team?
Yeah.
Are you winning?
No, we haven't started yet.
Oh, I see. Well, it looks like you've been doing had a pretty busy year so far, Kevin. 10 years old, it looks to me like you have a pretty busy schedule. And I'm going to be around to your house early again like I try to every year, so get to bed early. And no peeking this year, all right? Okay. Now tell me, have you been good or bad? 80-20. 80-20. Now, does that mean 80 bad and 20 good? Or 80 bad and 20 good? Well, I'm going to put 80 bad and 20 good then, if you want me to put that in the book, do you?
20?
Okay. We'll see you then.
At least he's honest.
He's honest. 80 bad. Boy, I haven't had any that high so far this year. You won the award on that too, Kevin. Now, Carrie Ann. And you're next, okay?
Can we switch knees, Santa?
You bet.
For the camera?
You bet. How are you?
Thanks.
Got your list all ready for Santa Claus?
I don't know.
We're going to find out in a minute, aren't we? I understand you're in Mrs. Hyde's class, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you like Mrs. Hyde?
Yeah.
In the third grade?
Yeah.
I understand you're quite a singer, too, is that right?
Yeah.
And you played one of the fairies in Cinderella program?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
A very good student and always trying to do really good, is that right? Well, I'm sure glad my elves get good reports for me. You're in the CTR class and was baptized June 25th.
That's my birthday.
That's your birthday and you turned, let me think, 8 years old on the 25th. That's right. You're in the Zimmers middle show team. Tell me a little bit about the Zimmers. What do they do?
They dance.
And do they dance all around town or all over the state or where? Just places. Now, I understand you love to dance. Is that right? You love to color and you love to play soccer and all the softball. Is that right? What else do you like to do?
Play dolls.
Play dolls? Mm-hmm. Do you keep your room straight all the time with your dolls, or do you keep it quite messy with them?
Quite
messy. Quite messy. Are you going to get it cleaned up a little bit this year for me? Okay. Now, I know you've been thinking about your list. Tell me what you want for Christmas.
Little makeup.
Okay.
Watches that change with my sisters.
Oh, you want it. Watches that change? All right. What else? And that's all. Boy, you got a pretty smile. Did anybody ever tell you that? Your mom. Well, your mom's got good taste. Okay, have you been good or bad?
Good.
You've been good. Okay, get to bed early. What are you going to leave me for Christmas this year?
Cookies.
A what?
Cookies.
Some cookies. You're going to leave me anything to drink with them?
Milk.
Some milk? Do I just get one glass, or are you going to leave one for Rudolph? 12 of them. One for each one of my reindeer? Oh, I see. Well, that will be very, very good. That's about 2 gallon, I think. Okay, well, we'll see you then, and I'll put good. Okay? All right. Sherry Ann is good. Now, our anxious young man, Curtis. Come on up here, Curtis. 7 years old. Let's see what we're going to talk about with Curtis. Get your list ready for me.
I only have one thing I want.
And what's that?
A Nintendo game, Zelda.
Well, you want the Nintendo game what?
Zelda.
Zelda. So if your brother gets the machine, you want this game just for you, huh?
Yeah, but we're only going to be able to play one game. We're getting more, I think.
Oh, you hope.
Mm-hmm.
I see. I would sure hope. And I'd be an awful good boy. That's a pretty nice present, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Mrs. Gates is your teacher
mm-hmm.
in second grade.
Mm-hmm.
You're always doing your very best, she tells me.
Mm-hmm.
And you're an excellent student, too. Is that right? And you was also a narrator for Cinderella, wasn't you? Oh, the ending. And what did you say? Do you remember?
Yeah.
Well, why don't you tell me what you said at the end of Cinderella? The end? Is that what you said?
No.
Oh, well, tell me what you said.
Well, I can't remember the whole thing.
Quite a bit.
Most of it.
Oh, well, just tell me the parts you remember.
So, as you see.
Come on,
you
can get started. Okay, ready, go.
And play as he's tender and a princess, happily ever after, just as sweet and tall. You might be interested to know that historical records show that Cinderella's friends, Anna and Agnes, did indeed become her ways of winning. And Kathleen was a pig in Vassar to China and got her whiskey, travel and see the world. Wormy and Merle, well, they learned how to pick up their own shoes and own clothes. And Lady Wyndham eventually became court pharmacist. And Lolly and the Goose Fairies, they're somewhat a mystery, but when dreams and wishes need a little magic to come true, there's usually a good fairy about from the Riverdale Elementary School course. Thank you, and good night or morning. And then I bow and
well, that was very good. How long ago did you have to memorize that?
A
couple of months ago?
Just a couple of weeks ago.
Oh, a couple of weeks ago.
And the first time I got it, that was very close to the point when we were going to do it.
I see. Well, I think it's great you can remember. That's the beautiful thing about being young, I think, huh? There's more storage room for memory. I know the older you get, there's less that you can remember, and you can't remember why. That you don't know about that, though, do you? Some of the big kids in here do, though.
Yeah.
And I understand you give good talks in primary, and you're in the CTR class. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
You also like sports.
Mm-hmm.
Do you do any tumbling?
Yep.
Well, what do you like to do in tumbling best?
Backhand
springs. I bet you're really good at those.
Not really.
Oh, you're just learning?
Yeah.
I see. I bet you'll get her, though. You're good at softball and soccer and basketball, and you like to play them, don't you?
I don't really like to play basketball. I don't usually play it, though.
Is that right? Do you ever play basketball with your brother?
Sometimes.
Can he beat you?
Yeah.
Just because the hoop's higher for him.
Ah, the hoop's higher. That's right. I bet if you practice, though, you could give that brother some competition. You don't think so? See, he likes to play the big boys, and he's a big boy, and I bet you could beat him.
Yeah, but Carrie Ann is also a tumbler, too.
Oh, and is she doing really well?
Mm-hmm.
You like?
The best cartwheel.
I see. And one thing that's always nice about you is you're always smiling, too. Do you practice that?
No.
Do you paint it on in the morning?
No.
Well, how come you're always smiling? Are you always happy?
Sometimes.
And I understand that you like teddy bears, too.
Mm-hmm.
A whole room full. And they're all neat and tidy and straight, too,
mm-hmm.
aren't they? And do they look just like your sister's room? Hers is kind of messy tonight.
Yeah, she has a whole bunch on her shelf, but I just keep some of them in and sleep at night with them.
I see. Well, I think that's very good. Will you keep it straight for me on Christmas? Will your room be really neat and clean on Christmas Eve?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, now, have you been good or bad? 110. 110
bad.
100 good, 110%. That's a fair guess. Let's go 100% good and 10% bad. That's kind of playing the edge on the odds. Okay, well, we'll see you. Okay? 110%, that's a bargain. Okay, now let's talk to all the Jacobs kids. We're going to start with Courtney. Courtney, how are you?
Fine.
Did you dress up with that cute shirt for Santa Claus tonight?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I sure like it. You look so pretty. What is it you want for Christmas?
This one doll called Dolly Surprise.
Little Miss Makeup and Dolly Surprise. Anything else? Nothing else, huh? Let me see in here what kind of a report I have on you this year. 7 years old.
Mm-hmm.
In the second grade.
Mm-hmm.
You love your teacher and having a lot of fun at school. Had a great year with dancing and won lots of team performances, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
I understand you went all the way to Arizona.
Mm-hmm.
And tell me about winning first place in Weber County.
I had to go to and my cousin and my friend had to
too. I see, and there was a dance. I see. And did you win that one, too?
Mm-hmm.
Pretty close? That's good. And your soccer team didn't lose a game?
So yeah. I said they tied one.
They tied one. Well, that's not a loss, is it? That's good. You did pretty good on that. And you're great with your sister, and you help around the house.
Not
my gosh. You're a great sister, then, aren't you? To all your brothers. Is that right? And you help really a lot around the house and a hard worker, right? Oh, gosh, old Santa misunderstood what he was thinking, didn't he? Yeah, I do that sometimes. Is Anything else you want for Christmas you want to tell me about? Just the two things? Uh-huh. Have you been good or bad, Courtney?
Good.
You've been good. That pretty well fits everything that I hear, except for sometimes you and your brothers have a few problems. How we do with your brothers and a little bit of fighting now and then. Are you winning those fights, or are you just trying to avoid them? A little of both. I know that around your house at this time of year, seems to be a lot of time spent trying not to fight so that I'll come to your house. Is that right? It's really important. I make sure everything is nice and clean. Okay. And I've got you doing good. Okay? All right. Bye-bye. Okay, now let's talk to Trevor. My 10-year-old fifth grader, right? Mm-hmm. How are you doing?
Fine.
I sure like your shirt. Those are really cute.
Santa Janet.
Your mom made them. I understand that she's into making shirts this year. And is she making lots of them?
I don't know if it's lots or kind of lots and kind of lots. But she does make some for everyone, the Nutcracker.
Well, that's really nice. Are you still doing many inventions this year?
Mm-hmm.
Are you? What are you trying to invent this year?
Well, so far I don't know right now, but I have invented a way to make artificial acid.
Artificial acid?
Electrocute water.
To electrocute water?
Okay.
Now, what are you going to do with that?
I don't know.
Oh, you've got it invented, but you don't know what you're going to use it for. Well, I see. Where have you been doing this invention? In Mother's Cosmetics, maybe? Where about?
In the basement.
That's the scariest part. The science project in the basement, you see. Does Mom and Dad know you're down there doing science projects?
Yeah, I know that.
It's rotten.
Oh, it's rotten. Yeah, the batteries ran out.
I see. And do you use the water in some kind of a battery for storage of energy? Is that what you use it for?
I use it to destroy the floating stuff which is there. They use it for life preservers on ships.
Let's see, and does it blow up the is it nitrogen?
Oh, it's styrofoam.
Oh, styrofoam.
Yeah, that's why it destroys.
Oh, my word, sounds like you've been using gasoline. That'll destroy it. You wouldn't use that in the house, would you?
Right.
That's a good boy. Let's see here. I know why Garfield's on your shirt, because he's one of your favorite folks. Is that right? Lots of Garfields, and you're a good artist with Garfield, I understand. And you draw Garfield about on everything you find. Is that right? And your soccer team also didn't lose, right?
Undefeated. Yeah, except for the last year again.
Oh, I see.
A few times.
I see. And do you like to play soccer?
Mm-hmm.
Great. You're working hard in school, he loves to read and loves arts. That's your two favorite subjects? Won first place in a reflections contest.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me what kind of a contest that was.
Well, it's one where you can write stories, songs, or poems, or draw pictures about anything, but this year it's something you like, or write music. And there's something else. I forgot what it was.
Oh, I see. And you won first place.
And the school won second place in the state.
Well, that's great. And what kind of a thing did you do to win?
Draw a wolf howling at the moon on a mountain, which inside the mountain was a cave with some other wolves.
Well, that's really good. You're really a smart boy, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I always like talking to you every year because you keep Santa really thinking about things. And that's really nice. You're doing a great job getting used to your new contacts.
I'm already used them. They're
mine
right now.
I think they look really nice, too. They're pretty and blue. Oh, Santa, they're brown or they're clear. My eyes aren't blue.
My contacts are brown.
Sarah.
Oh, Sarah. Oh, wow, I did a great job there.
I can't believe it.
That's great, and you're a great brother.
Except for when I get invited with my sister.
I see. But we've already talked to your sister, and she's agreed that we're not going to do too many of those, aren't we? Okay. Now, what do you want for Christmas?
Paper, pencils, pen, scissors, tape, glue, paint, a cobra guy from G.I. Joe's named Dr. Viper, some other G.I. Joe's, the cobra bug. I know this one I'm not getting, but the PSL 2000.
Oh, I see. And why am I not going to bring you that, do you think?
My mom told me I can't have it.
Oh, well, I would never violate Mom's statement if she says, no, then Santa's not going to do it. I used to do that when your mom was a little girl, and she really got mad at me. So I just listened to Mom, and if she says no, that's good enough for Santa. Anything else?
Lots of surprises.
Lots of surprises. How about just one surprise?
Okay.
Just one? Okay, I'll see what I can do for you. Okay? Now, have you been good or bad, except for your sister?
Okay, 98.71% good and 1.29% bad.
Well, that's some pretty good calculation. How long have you been thinking about that? I think that even adds up. It does. Well, I have no question in my mind about that. Well, that's very good. Okay, so that's 98.71 good and 1.29 bad. Is that correct? Okay, well, I'll put that by your name. Is there anything else you'd like to tell me? Okay. Well, thanks for being such a good boy, okay?
Okay.
And keep inventing away safely.
Okay.
All right. 29.1 and 98.71. That's very, very good. All right. Now let's talk. To Jared. This is my big boy. Beth and Jared, they're getting so big, you know. How are you?
Good.
Good. What are you doing over in the ninth grade?
Good.
Good. What do you want for Christmas?
A skateboard.
A skateboard?
Yeah.
What else? Just a skateboard.
Yeah.
Been a pretty good boy this year?
Yeah.
What do you do that you like to do best?
Listen to my radio.
Listen to your radio. You listen it down in your room or where?
Yeah.
You always keep it down and quiet so it doesn't bother Mom and Dad. I don't know why most of the radios today have such loud switches, do you? Why the volumes are all so loud on them? Maybe they should cut them down 50% or 49.3%.
Yeah.
You go to T.H. Bell last year or this year? Increased your grade point average.
Yeah.
That's really good. What did you do to raise that?
Some lady helped me.
I see. And I understand that you're in big demand by all of the girls at THL.
Of course.
Does that bother you at all? Well, that's nice. And something you've done really a lot, and I appreciate that, is helping the handicapped kids in the horse riding. All summer long, is that right?
Uh-huh.
Did you enjoy that?
Yeah.
Well, that's very nice. You helped your grandpa out in the cherry orchard, too.
Yeah.
How about that? Did you enjoy that?
Yeah.
You helped your sister with your homework, with her homework?
Uh-huh.
Good. Anything else you'd like to know, old Santa? Let's pretend right now that you're Santa, and you just arrived in the family tonight, and you're going to leave them one present for everyone. What would that present be?
Skateboard.
You're going to give one to everybody.
No.
Well, it's got to be one for everybody.
A little piece of gum.
A little piece of gum.
Yeah.
Well, I appreciate your generosity. Okay, we'll see you. Did you tell me if you were good or bad, Jared?
No, he didn't.
I'm good.
No.
Much of a percent. Courtney, do you agree with that? Has he been good?
58.2%. 50-50.
Yeah, I agree with that.
50-50. All right, let's start with Seth.
Yay.
He wants to get here and tell me all about his successful football season at Ogden Highland. How are you, Seth?
Oh, pretty good.
How's things going at school?
Good.
Good. You got a list all ready for me for what you want for Christmas?
Yeah.
Why don't you start and tell me?
Okay. I want snowboard, new ski stuff, clothes, tapes, stuff like that.
Oh, just stuff like that.
Yeah.
Do you think you've been good enough to deserve all that?
Mm-hmm.
Let's read your report here and see. 13th place in the world tumbling meet?
Yeah.
How many was in the competition?
Over 200.
200. Well, that's pretty good. You still doing a lot of tumbling?
Not really.
You kind of give that up?
Yeah.
And you went on your first undate, is that right?
Yeah.
What happened on your undate?
We went to eat and we went to the dance and the dance.
I see. You went to Wendy's and had some teriyaki, is that right?
Yeah.
And you spilled it on your lap?
No.
I see. I really appreciate everything you're doing at school and helping with the family, and I'll try and bring you a surprise.
All right.
Okay. Now, have you been good or bad?
I've been good.
Okay. Thank you, Seth.
Yeah.
Boy, that Josh knew when to show up.
He just gets there on call, you know.
Really? That's pretty good. Okay, Devery. And how's Devery?
Fine.
Seventh grade. My word, what are you doing all the way up in the seventh grade? You're still supposed to be just three. You know that? You're getting too big. Tell me, what do you want for Christmas?
Some nutcrackers.
Some nutcrackers? Mm-hmm. Oh, like the ones that Mom has all over the house?
Yeah.
I see. Mm-hmm. What else would you like?
Some clothes.
Some clothes. Okay. And some nutcrackers.
Uh-huh.
And what else?
And some surprises.
And some surprises.
Yeah.
Okay. How are you doing in the nutcracker this year? I understand that you've been on television in some commercials.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw you here just a little bit ago, and you did a very good job.
Thank you.
You bet. Do you like to do that?
Mm-hmm.
Do you? Mm-hmm. Well, let me look in my notes again and see what kind of report I have. Straight A's over there at Mount Ogden, is that right? Straight A's. Mrs. Benio says you're the greatest violin player that ever lived. Is that true?
Well, not really.
Just maybe doing pretty good?
Yeah.
Okay. And you was the whiz at Weber State College, or was you the whiz or just played in that?
I was a munchkin.
You was a munchkin in the whiz.
Uh-huh.
That's kind of a fun show. And Hansel and Gretel, what part did you play in Hansel and Gretel?
A gingerbread kid.
A gingerbread kid.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see. He's in the party scene in the Nutcracker?
Mm-hmm.
And what kind of a party scene is that? I don't remember.
Beer party, isn't it?
it's where Clara's friends have a big party. And all the people in town are invited, and we go and have a party, and then we leave.
I see. And your hair is all in ringlets, is that right?
Uh-huh.
And I understand that you really steal the show when you do that. Sam is really proud of you. Do you like to steal the show?
Uh-huh.
Do you?
Uh-huh.
Well, that's kind of a nice, gentle attitude. You sure have pretty hair, too.
Thank you.
Have you thought of anything you'd like to tell Santa that I haven't asked?
If I've been good or bad.
Okay. Have you been good or bad?
I've been nice.
2 good, and 1.8 bad.
Oh. we got a 1.
Not bad, but very...
98.1.
Well, we can fit it all right in.
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll put down 98.2 and 1.98 bad. How's that?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, we'll see.
What if...
Okay, Josh. You got here just in time, didn't you, bud?
Uh-huh.
Now tell me what you've been doing tonight.
I've been doing the Nutcracker.
Where did they do the Nutcracker tonight?
In Salt Lake.
In Salt Lake. Was it fun?
Uh-huh.
And I understand you're doing a good job in your part in the Nutcracker.
Yeah.
Yeah. And tell me what that part is again.
Which cast?
A and B.
In A, I'm doing the mouse, and B, I'm doing a party boy.
I see. And you're not on the C cast, I guess. And you're on the C cast.
Uh-huh.
And what do you play in the C cast?
The nephew.
And what do you do in the D cast?
The nephew.
Now, how about the E cast?
No E cast.
Whoa, that's a lot of cast. You play lots of parts, don't you? Yes. Well, let's see my report on Josh. Fourth grade. Go to Grandview Acres, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
And your teacher is again Mrs. Kimball, and you had her in the first grade, is that right?
Right.
Well, my word, how come she's in the fourth grade now? Is she getting older?
Yes, she passed.
Yeah, she passed. You're doing great with her, is that right?
Yeah.
Do you like her?
Yes.
Your team is undefeated in soccer this year.
Yeah.
It was the coach, huh, Josh?
No. It was the
son of the coach, huh?
No, the assistant coach.
Oh.
Assistant coach.
No, it was homie. He was the guy from Iran. What?
Iran. Oh, I see. And you was in The Wiz and Hansel and Gretel. And I also watched you on TV in the Nutcracker commercial.
Yeah.
That, you look really cute on television. Did anybody ever tell you that?
No.
They didn't, huh? Well, you did. You looked really good. And let's see. You went on tour with Ballet West in Spokane.
Mm-hmm.
Was that fun? He's in every show, just like you told me. The Mouse, the Nephew, and the Farm Boy. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, let's see.
Don't read that out loud.
Oh. Josh took a present to Clara and kissed her on the mouth. You hit some mistletoe in your bag, and you snuck up on her, didn't you?
I didn't get to do it, though.
That was some pretty good planning, wasn't it, Josh?
Yeah.
What did she say when you was going to do that?
She didn't say anything. She never found out.
She never found out. Who foiled your trick? Did you lose your mistletoe?
No.
You just decided not to?
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Now tell me what you want for Christmas.
I want one of those bells from your sleigh.
Okay.
Surprises.
And some surprises. Just a bell and some surprises.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Have you been good or bad?
Good.
Good. Okay. Well, keep up the good work in the Nutcracker. Okay?
Yeah.
All right. We'll see you. See, I shouldn't let them see what I have written in my book.
You got laughing gas.
Well, we finished all of the children that are under the age of 15. And now we're going to do all of the children over the age of 15.
But
nobody's older.
So they're just kids. They're just older kids. Just ask them. Oh, that's it.
We're just in the next group. We're in the B cast.
See, they're in the B cast.
And what are we?
Yeah. They're in the B cast as well. It doesn't get any worse than B. Okay, let's see what Brent's been doing this year. Come on over, Brent.
Sit on his lap.
I understand that you're in the bishopric and busy at work. And so I'd like to give you a button to wear because everything up to the age of 40 is just rehearsal. And now you're in the real world. Everything up to 40 is just rehearsal. And now you're in the real world. What would you like for Christmas this year?
A new van.
A new van?
Yeah! We'll agree to that.
Okay.
One that starts in the morning.
One that'll start for you.
Yeah.
Everything else going all right for you?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Thank you, Zach.
You bet. Okay, Tamara.
Mommy.
It's not working.
Oh. Mom's here.
How are you? Everything going pretty well this year? Good. Well, I understand that you and your husband are both hard at work. Hard at work making a living to kind of supply things for the family. Is that right?
That's my idea.
I see. And I understand that sometimes you have a little tough time balancing the budget. Is that right?
Yeah, you could say that.
Okay, I'd like to give you a keychain so that everybody knows that you're expensive but worth it. Merry Christmas.
No, that's right.
Okay, we are.
You gotta get a video.
Yeah, when I get done with the adults, then we'll open up the press.
As long as you're quiet.
Brianna.
Brianna.
My elves have told me, Brianna, that you haven't had a lot of fun this year. Is that right?
But I have or haven't?
You haven't. Haven't had a lot of fun. And it's just not your nature to giggle and act crazy.
Probably not.
So I brought you disguise so that you can go about and wear the surprise and giggle and be crazy and nobody will ever know. There we go.
Okay.
Should we call him Groucho Jacobs now?
Yeah.
Okay, Jen. I understand you've been really busy in the stars this year helping Courtney.
Yeah.
See, you've been trying to earn some money creating the sweatshirts that we see here tonight. And your elves keep telling me Jana needs more Wonder Under. More Wonder Under. So what I've got you is some Wonder Unders. And I hope these fit. I hope your camera's in color. That's awfully pretty red. That's very nice. And I'm not going to tell anyone how I knew the size. Okay, Trace. I understand you've been trying for years to get a deer, and you finally shot one this year.
We did. We did. We got lucky this year.
That's good. So to celebrate that, I'd like to give you a ribbon so that everybody knows you got one. Okay?
But it's not in the package.
It's what?
Well, let's do this. Trace got a deer, and congratulations. Paul needs to know, have him call me, okay? And I'll verify it.
All right.
We have
to get a picture.
How big a deer was it?
It was a little 4-point.
Oh, a little 4-point. Well, good. Okay. Santa sometimes makes mistakes. Santa tries not to, but you know how it is.
It's the help you get.
That's right. Getting good help. Okay, Sherry.
Uh-oh.
Now, I hope I have the one for Sherry packed tonight.
Probably the right elf picture.
Yeah. I understand that your greatest fear, Sherry, is getting a large bug. Is that true? Well, Santa's getting really personal this year, isn't he? And so this year I brought you one that's just a cube.
Let's see it.
Let's see.
Now that's something to put on your fridge every morning and think about, it, okay?
Mom, put it up,
Mom. Oh, Santa's really with me. Okay, Dawn.
Courtney, go back to your chair.
Well, I've been noticing, Dawn, that you've been losing more hair, and people have been avoiding you more and more and more. Is that true?
No, God only made some perfect heads. He put hair on the rest of them.
I see, and I agree with that. So I brought you a button to help improve your status, and it says, hang out with bald guys, and you won't get in anybody's hair. You bet. Merry Christmas to you. All right, artist. How are you? Good. Fine. Are you having a Merry Christmas yet? Good. Well, I understand that you went on a trip to California, and you was quite an expert in what you did there, I understand. Let's see. While Dawn was driving, you kept saying, turn here, Dawn. No, here, turn left. No, stop, back up. No, right here, just fine. Is that true?
True.
So because of your expertise, I'm bringing you an official backseat driver's license. So the next time when you go, Dawn will know that you're officially authorized and licensed to be a backseat driver.
Thank you.
I hope that works out okay.
It will.
Okay. All right. Okay. Well, I think that now would be a great time to open your fridge.
Area.
Is that just what you wanted?
Jenna,
great.
Not a bad
great.
I got the ones I wanted, but I didn't think I'd get it.
Well, Merry Christmas to you. Open it up and let's see.
Yeah.
You like your bargain? Oh, I bet you'll be able to make lots of baskets with that one.
I did.
Thanks, Santa.
You betcha. You're welcome.
Courtney.
Well, kids, it's the time when I'm just about ready to go. But before I go, I want to read you one story, and then I have some candy in my bag I want to give you. So if you'll stay with just one more thought before we leave, let's sing Jingle Bells, okay?
Oh, yeah.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. O'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtails ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Very, very good. Now, I've got one more thing I'd like you to have. So everybody come and get one.
Thank you.
Now, let's go.
Say thank you.
Thank you. Oh, there you go. That's a puzzle, isn't it?
You can't read it.
Did everybody get one?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Well, let me read you one more story before I go. The most precious joy of Christmas isn't pine or mistletoe, and it isn't wreath or holly. It's not sleigh bells in the snow. It's the wish that lifts the spirit and makes all of our joys increase. It's the wish that's sent from heart to heart for love and hope and peace. May Christmas bring you peace on earth to ever live and last. A faith instilled within your heart even though Christmas has passed. This friendly greeting holds a prayer, and it's filled with warmth and cheer. From jolly old St. Nicholas, I wish you all Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. So with that, I'm going to head on my way, and I wish you all a Merry Christmas, and get to bed early. Make sure your rooms are cleaned on. No messes this year. Okay.
Oh, wait, Santa, can we have one group picture?
Oh, sure. One big group picture would be great.
Okay, kids, leave your presents. Now go up and stand by Santa, quick. You sit on your butt.
There.
Mom. Kevin, out so we can see Kevin.
No way.
They'll be fine. Yeah, you can open both of those. Josh, hand me the sack. Thank you.
Gentlemen, I really appreciate it. Had a lot of fun losing.
You want to open them?
Josh?
Oh.
You get to open your present from Jessica and Carly.
What is it? Where is it?
And whomever else.
Come on,
okay.
Come on.
Okay.
Wait a minute.
Grandpa's got to give the orders.
You have to get a set so you can put them in and take your money.
Actually, Josh, Lance could open his. And
okay.
Could open his.
Huh?
All of them?
I don't think some of them can open.
Josh.
No? Well, maybe I will.
Well, since
you'll be in limbo.
Josh and Deb are the Lewis. I thought
at least we'll give some up. Yeah, for the gifts.
Well, Debbie can open one of them.
Okay, you tell her what not.
So I can open all of mine?
No.
Josh, do it fast.
Josh, isn't that mine?
No.
You sure?
Uh-huh.
She does. She has to sit behind the chair.
Charlotte, move over. It won't look cute with a head on the chair look.
How do
you know?
How do you know?
Newest member of the family. That big piece of ham in there.
Okay, ready? Get Shannon and Charlotte and Joanne.
I don't know.
Here, move in. Okay. One, two, three.
Oh, wait, I forgot to put my
hair. Oh, sorry. Okay, Bard, Mary, Arnie, here we go. Bard,
Mary, Arnie.
Bard, this is good. I like the look. Okay, is this posed? Is this posed? Oh, Roland, get over there with him. Get Roland, get with Arnie, and I'll take a picture.
I'll take all mine.
Oh, all right. She can open hers.
Tonight?
Yes, because I'm not going to be there.
Well, then you can open mine.
Okay.
And you can open mine.
Thank you.
And yeah. Josh can open mine, but well, you'll have to open yours later.
Which one?
We have you guys, and we'll have you give yours later.
Okay.
Don't open the rest of them. Just open some of them. Okay,
yeah.
I'm coming.
We open them out. In the wardrobe. They're doing it in March. This is what we don't have it. Is that right?
Or likes it.
Just keep getting it. Oh, that is wonderful. Okay, is Debra opening one?
Can you hurry a little bit?
Yeah.
I'm trying. I hate Christmas.
Either way.
Oh, no.
It's
You rip as you
want.
When it's cold out, it's embarrassing. Look at my car.
Oh, yeah, you go from the
Josh, show me your rip.
Carly, you hit that last time.
We do.
Mom. Can I have my other thing? Oh, darling. Thank you.
Did Jess open anything?
Yes, Jess just got one from us right there.
Jess and Carly do, I think.
Yes,
okay. Go ahead, baby.
Shouldn't Carly go since she's younger than I?
No, we're going for maturity.
Carly,
I'm maturity instead of looks.
Go,
Pumpkinhead. Okay, Pumpkinhead.
From
Fern.
You believe it.
Was it from?
Fern. When'd you get that, Mom?
This is
Ronnie.
Oh, that's
Carly.
Thank
you. Whose camera's that? She's just learning uno dos.
You got some, you got. Is this your?
I don't know.
Smile.
Yeah, it is.
Well, you should smile. Stop it up and I'm high beam.
Oh,
stop.
I'm not high beam.
Come on, high beam.
Let's see
what
this
way.
Yeah.
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 What does it say? It is. It's going. Look. It is recording. Hi. The light isn't flashing. What's it doing? Now it's flashing. What's wrong with the video?
Whatever yours, Sherry. You can open one of yours.
Oh, I stuck some in the sack here. I wonder what the video's doing.
I can scroll pretty well.
And you can Luann, you can open one.
What is it?
Not that one. That's me.
Wow, try it on.
That is a loner, you're right.
Yeah, wear it. Yeah.
Just my size.
Yeah.
Do you
matches the set that's
it's
right now.
It is thin up. Here, look
that's
cool. Stand up. Stand up, Seth.
No,
it's going.
Wow, how cute. Thank you, Trey.
Thank you.
Of course not. Did you go shopping and pick it out?
great. Everyone open
you thought that was medium.
Would you want me to spray bubbles
thank
on the beer?
You very much. You're welcome. Smile.
Thank you.
More fancy post.
Thank you. That's
nice. I thought
okay,
it was a
Sherry,
good
you
color.
Great
color.
Can we? I'll go like that when you're ready.
Okay. Christmas isn't only presents in Santa Claus, it's also the birth of Christ. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from the Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, every one into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judah and into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was the house of the lineage of David. To be taxed with Mary at his espoused wife, being great with child, and so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And then they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David, its Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes lying in a manger. And suddenly there was an angel of a multitude of heavenly hosts praying God and saying, Glory to God in the highest and on peace, and peace good toward men.
That's good, Josh. Thank
I don't think it was over. It's from Santa, Mom. To me and to Jeffrey.
What is this? A nutcracker.
Very good. Josh.
Who's hiding behind that blue box? Who's next?
Seth.
Seth's next.
Okay, Sethy. Why don't you open one?
Take the pen, Sean.
To me from, it doesn't say.
We will.
You got one of those last night, Charlie.
Yeah, I know. I want to fix the same one.
Josh, your turn. Josh is opening one. Who's it from, Josh?
What?
Who is it from?
Santa.
You know what, Mom?
What?
Mine has me.
Oh, cool.
No, it doesn't.
It's those aren't the instructions.
I flip paper.
Cool. Military.
No, this has instructions.
Nuh-uh.
Seth, go ahead. Hold it.
Here we go.
Rip it open. Rip it open. Tear me apart. Seth, they're not weights. It's too light to
weight. Oh, my gosh.
Is it animals? So it's getting jealous. But it's so neat about that. Worth more than you are.
Wait a minute. I can't get you. Seth, look at me. Seth, look at me.
Good tag, huh?
Ready?
I could hypnotize you.
One. Two.
Josh, I think our presents are the same.
Three.
Bring the camera here. Bring it here.
Okay, well, are these two presents the same?
Get that off your nose.
I can't do it.
Mom, are these two presents the same? Look. Well, we can do it at the same time and then I'll be separate. Wait a second.
Josh,
you
would have to wait.
Okay, where's that? Oh! Okay. Oh, mine's tissue paper.
Open.
Okay.
Open, Josh.
Oh, okay. Signatures of all the Rossmeyers.
Let's see, Josh.
Gnarly. My turn.
Is this wrong first?
Yeah.
It is. Oh, he's turning
black.
Sherry.
Your turn.
Where are you?
Oh, wait a
second. I'm opening this one, Mom.
It's okay. It's for me.
Is that the last present?
No, I have three more.
No.
Oh, that one, okay, that's okay.
It's from White Sox.
No, it's not. No, it's not. Sorry.
Except for me. Me personal life.
Oh, it's it is
that.
For
Christmas.
That. Me.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yeah. It's your match black car.
Oh,
my
lovely.
You're gonna love it.
I missed the back.
Sorry.
Oh, Beth.
Careful.
Christmas.
Said you like to
say
boxes.
It's flat. Yeah, that's what I call flat out.
Flat out, flat. Careful, I love it. Don't bust it. It's very breakable.
Is it?
Very. I mean, don't even press down on it.
It might go.
It's not going, is it?
Nice, Dad.
Yeah, it was. From Mom and Dad and Grandma and Grandpa.
Me. I got glass.
You
so
have to be careful.
Seth, what did you get?
I got Indian headdress for the Indian costume, ski coat and ski pants, really nice shirts, a nutcracker, tape, a watch.
What kind?
Lovato. And a puzzle. Binding, this puzzle. Go ahead.
And where y'all? What was the last present?
Oh, a plane ticket to Palm Springs.
Okay, my turn. Okay.
Mom, what'd you get?
I got a wrong for Courtney's
dress.
Right there.
Okay.
Courtney.
Oh my God.
Where's grandpa?
That one.
Where's grandpa?
Grandpa's coming in just a minute. Just wait till I wipe him in here, cause he's just.
This is too crazy.
Courtney,
too crazy.
Did they buy your clothes?
Here, another present. We don't have
to. See you in the family. See you in the family
now. Oh, thank you. That's yours.
Is this another family?
Janet?
Janet,
we left your present.
Hey, that's mine.
Oh, that's my pile. Okay, is that Jared here?
Of course.
Yes.
Jared.
Let's put the plastic bag in here.
Yes.
Here's a plastic bag for Barbie. Here's a plastic bag for Barbie. Here's a plastic bag for Barbie.
These don't have eggs on it.
This has a present on it.
I bet they didn't. Look at this. That is
nice.
To your mom.
You can guess what that is.
Grandma, that's Grandma, that's yours. The green box on that,
Grandma.
Grandmama,
somebody.
Okay.
Grandma, that's yours.
Grandma,
right,
what are these for?
Yeah.
Three. I only can smile once.
Three. You've got enough.